The Transmission Rehabilitation and Expansion Program, established by TCN and endorsed by various donors, were prepared in line with the 20-year Transmission Expansion Master Plan. The five projects earmarked for implementation under the program, in the total sum of $1.57 billion, are on track, as TCN has sharpened its implementation capacity through four well-staffed and established, adequately staffed project management units. We are working to ensure that the projects become effective before the end of this year, all the five projects. In order to achieve economy of scale and satisfy the requirement of donor agencies, all the major procurements will be done centrally, but day-to-day implementation will be handled at the various regional offices across the country. TCN is working hard to complete many of the ongoing projects funded under the FGN budget. This explains the effort of TCN in clearing several of the stranded containers. On this note, we thank the Honorable Minister of Power, Works and Housing, Mr. Babatunde Reggie Fashola, for negotiating 50% discount with the concerned shipping and terminal agents. We have commenced implementation of some of the projects whose contractors were cleared. TCN engineers will complete all projects abandoned, as well as those whose contractors have shown lack of capacity. TCN has terminated, for example, the Wala Lembe and Dambata 132 KV 33 substations project, both in Kano, and handed over to the implementation of those projects to the Kano Transmission, Kaduna Transmission Region. The GIT and the Federal Lloyd, which are contracts under the NEGIP project, which is financed by the World Bank, have also been handed over to Port Harcourt and Abuja region. That is, they are going to take over and install those transformers that the contractor could not do them at the speed that we want. TCN is ready to do whatever it can to support all laudable effort aimed at improving the sector. It is in this spirit that TCN is hosting the implementation of the Crescent project, conceived and supported by the Honorable Minister, as approved by the Federal Executive Council few weeks ago. The core team has been constituted and office accommodation also provided. They have commenced work in earnest. On this note, we wish to thank His Excellency, the Honorable Minister of Power, Works and Housing, for getting us yet another opportunity to play host at the monthly power sector meeting. It is our fervent wish that the deliberation of today will be fruitful and rewarding. Finally, we hope our guests will find some measure of comfort in the modest arrangement we have tried to put in place. Where lapses exist, we crave your pardon, please. Once more, thank you very much for your attention.
The objective of the electricity industry is to deliver power that's reliable, affordable to Nigerian homes, offices and industries. Though much work remains to achieve this objective, there are signs that progress has been made. More homes, businesses and industries must generate their own power to get reliable power. Many of them use diesel. Diesel importation has been declining over the last 2 years. Many are reported that they run their generators for noticeably few hours. This is progress. However, Nigeria still consumes about 300 million liters of diesel every month. Much of this is used to power generators. Most of it, about 75%, is imported, putting pressure on scarce foreign exchange. Assuming 40% of the consumption is used for power generation, and an average price of 200 naira per liter, electricity industry is losing 24 billion every month, largely to imported energy. At the same time, there is about 2,000 megawatts of electricity generating capacity that is unutilized. Therefore, the challenge of the moment before the industry is how to deliver the unutilized capacity to consumers who are willing to pay for it and are already paying dearly for alternatives. How can we domesticate the alternatives back into the electricity industry? Problems like this require creative solutions. We should all be willing to shift from fixed positions to try such creative solutions. The industry and its regulator should be willing to reset rules, responsibilities and creativity to facilitate solutions. We don't have any time to waste. There is 701.9 billion payment reassurance program is a creative solution that appears to be having the desired effect of stabilizing the gas and generation end of the electricity industry. If we think creativity constructively and focus on specific win-win projects, four policies provide effective tools to quickly resolve the challenges we now face. The first two, the eligible customer regulation and the meter service provider regulation, are already the subjects of detailed discussions and met regulatory action. The eligible customer regulation allows large consumers to buy their power directly from the then contract with TCM, DISCOs, and investors to have the power delivered to them. To plan an orderly win-win implementation of this policy, the Ministry is hosting a discussion with the Manufacturers Association of Nigeria and other interested large consumers of the policy on Tuesday, 13 February 2018. The meter service provider regulation can unlock investment into meters, which is urgently needed to build consumer trust and boost collection efficiency. Government seeks to apply that policy through a private company and local meter manufacturers to invest 39 million naira in meters as settlement of a court judgment against government. Some distribution companies are already perfecting and trying a third tool, franchising arrangements that enable customer-focused solutions for difficult customer populations. The Federal Executive Council has approved a fourth policy intervention that can quickly apply to the previous tools, in collaboration with the DISCOs to strengthen the whole industry. The Distribution Expansion Program aims to rapidly construct 2,500 MVA of dedicated 33 kV lines and package substations to deliver unutilized power to target consumers and DISCOs. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, it is our hope that we all put our heads together to serve the public that we so dearly wish to, so that we can improve productivity, improve on the economy generation of our teeming populace. I wish all of us happy deliberations in this power sector meeting this morning. Thank you very much.
Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram and YouTube for more information on the Transmission Company of Nigeria, TCN.